Time. It's after a couple week hiatus, we're back. It's another program. As these things tend to go, politics get involved, and some of the producers of Drive Time program with disagreements about format and. All I can say right now is that we haven't resolved fully our issues, but we really do hope that we can continue making the show here. I love doing it. We've had a couple good guests on this talk show. A lot of times I've just been me talking about life, and that's also been really good. This is the show that I drive and I talk, and I sometimes have guests that we get involved in here. An issue that came up as far as not being able to secure great guests. It has been a struggle. This format is a difficult one to survive in, and we really did want to go keep producing strong episodes. And we're all I can say right now is that it's on a episode by episode basis, and we've been assured that if we are going to get the axe, we'll at least get to record a goodbye episode. So that could be coming any day now. All I can say is that you're hearing now is not going to be. There's going to be at least one more after this. Hopefully 1,000 more. But I just want to let our fans and our listeners know that the end is nigh, potentially. And during the negotiations and disputes of the last couple weeks, that's why I haven't been on the air, and you haven't heard my voice via the YouTube, where the show is produced on YouTube.com. And also my website, vernonhall.com, and the embedded videos. It's an audio show only, but we do it via the YouTube. So that's somewhat confusing, but there's not a video component as of yet to Drive Time. And unless the show morphs into something else, I can't see that happening. We've talked about a lot of things. The good thing about this show is that it jumps around, and I feel comfortable giving you different types of shows and different types of monologues. So some have been personal, some have been about art, some have been about music, some have been about just current events and things in life, and it's a hot summer day right now, and my car doesn't have air conditioning, so I apologize for the windows being open, so with the sound you're hearing, but I have to have both windows open lest I overheat. But we'll just write out with it. I haven't been extremely forthcoming or honest with you, the listener, my fans. Fans of me in general, not just of the Drive Time program, but the fans of the Vernon Howell and the Vernon Howell group. Obviously, the Vernon Howell is a pseudonym, and it's the role that I am performing right now, and have been in control of for the last few months. Transitionally speaking, it's a transition from VH1 to VH2. Started taking place as far back as 2009. That's when I've been working for TVHG Inc. And VH1 Vernon Howe, who's retired, and his name is public, obviously, is Doug Smith, was the first Vernon Howe. And I am the second Vernon Howe, VH2. So we have VH1 and VH2. My identity has been somewhat up to there's been some dispute. I just wanted to, going forward today, kind of clear that out, clear some of that up, because I believe honesty is power, and I'm not trying to hide, and my identity, my history, and my qualifications to do this job, and I take it seriously, and the Vernon Howe brand is one of mystery, but also one of truth. In that sense, I think that we want all the people involved that I work with, and it is a team effort, and we do believe the time has come to be honest about who's who, because I won't be doing this forever. Within another year or another 50 years, I can pretty much guarantee you that there will be another Vernon Howe, maybe multiple Vernon Howes, potentially many Vernon Howes. And we want, much like, well, how does that work? Like, a guy, Caesar of the Roman Empire, and then when he died or something, they all started, people just became, Caesar became synonymous with king, so the position of a Caesar had its own name, like the Caesar, so such and such. So the Vernon Howe as a position is a title, like you would have president or CEO or king or Caesar or lord or mastermind or anything, like any sort of leader, you know, captain of the ship. If you want to look at the Vernon Howe group as a ship, and the position of captain, instead of just calling it captain, is Vernon Howe. You assume the identity of Vernon Howe. Also, another good example would be the University of Georgia's football team. Or athletic department of University of Georgia, they have a dog, a bulldog as a mascot, and they have an actual live bulldog, and I think the bulldog's name is UGA, UGA, they keep naming, you know, the bulldogs don't live forever, so they have a relatively short lifespan for dogs, I think, also. So they just keep renaming them. I mean, they're all named UGA. So UGA 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10. And I think they're up to like 17 or 18. I could be mistaken, but it's in the teens, I believe. And so I am VH2, and I've been doing this officially a few months ago, starting in 2012. So 2012 when I started, but again, I've been, you've heard my voice, and you've heard me on record since as early as 2009. Early 2009, maybe late 2008 even, is when I started working for the Vernon Howe Group, TVHG Incorporated. They cut my checks, so we've decided to use this, maybe our last couple shows that we've been producing. The drive time has been my personal little baby here. And, you know, I'm ready to say what my name is, and hopefully that'll clear some error, because there has been emails and questions. So my name is Chase Greeley. That's Chase Greeley, Chasegreeley, and it's a pleasure, and I hope to do this job for a long time, and I hope to produce other wonderful pieces of art and different things, of bits of culture, but this is maybe the last of a couple of draft time shows we're going to be able to do for you guys, so that's...